Up, Leo, it's West Coast Tarot with your end of November love general reading. This is for the lovely Leos, Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. This is a general love reading and may not resonate with every Leo out there. But if you like my style and I vibed with you, please like and subscribe to catch future West Coast Tarot videos. Also, if you want a personal reading with me, or if you want to know about any of the tarot decks that I use, all that information can be found down below, as well as how to contact me with business inquiries. So guys, this is a general reading. In a general, roles can be reversed, energies can be reversed, and cross watchers. This very well may play out from your perspective. So just apply it where it fits. If it's not for you, it's definitely not for you. So Spirit, tell me about the love energies surrounding Leo for the end of November going into December. What is the current energy and love surrounding Leo for the end of November, please? Tell me about Leos and the current love energy. Leos in love. End of November, please. Okay, so we have the Five of Spears reverse, the Hangman, Queen of Cups, Six of Spears, the World in reverse. Ooh, Death in reverse. Bottom of the deck, we have Judgment. So I feel like you guys are doing a lot of reflecting on something, a lot of reflecting on the past. You guys are really doing a lot of reminiscing. I feel like you're going through some sort of awakening here, thinking about past choices that you made and maybe what you would have done differently, and going forward, how you're going to do things differently and how you'll make different choices. You're going to do them more wiser. You're going to make sure that before you make a decision that you're more well-informed is what I see. Okay, so where you guys are coming from is Five of Spears in reverse. So I feel like you're really just in a place where you're trying to avoid conflict. You're just respecting differences. You're just trying to get along with people. You don't have time for drama. You don't really want to get involved in anything that if it doesn't feel right to you. I feel like you're just really kind of skating by, avoiding conflict and just really trying to be peaceful. I feel like you're just coming from a more peaceful place in your life and just really not wanting to get involved with things that don't raise up your vibrations or make you feel better about yourself, okay? Tell me about Leo, please. Where are they coming from? Why is Five of Spears here? Yeah, the High Priestess. So I feel like you're really just kind of being secretive right now. I feel like you're not really telling too many people about your plans. You're just doing a lot of meditation. You're listening to your inner voice. You know, you're going by what feels right to you and what doesn't feel right to you. You're searching for divine truth, and I feel like you just want to make better decisions going forward, okay? The High Priestess. Also, we have Pisces energy. High Priestess, please. Yeah, I feel like, you know, you're walking away from things that aren't serving you. You're avoiding people that you know don't add value to your life. You know, you don't want to suffer anymore. You don't want to lose anymore. I feel like, you know, sometimes it's scary, you know, to welcome change into your life. But I feel like, you know, you have to leave behind things that aren't serving you. You know, it's time to walk away. And your voice, you know, the inner voice told you to walk away from something that was too conflicting. So I feel like you guys are in a much better place right now. You're leaving the conflict in the past, okay? How you're being seen, we have the Hangman. So again, I don't really feel like you're making waves or doing too much right now. I feel like you're just kind of skating by, just kind of taking it easy. You're really just trying to get a new perspective on life. And I feel like, you know, you're working on releasing what's not serving you. And in the meantime, you're just a martyr. So I feel like you're really not going after like active relationships. I feel like you're just kind of taking a break. You're just chilling. You're just hanging there. Why is the Hangman here, please? How is Leo being seen? Ooh. Yeah, see, you don't want to fight. You don't want drama. You're just kind of just done. You know, you've given up on people that you know you can't change, and I feel like you don't want to be feeling overwhelmed anymore. You don't want to deal with a lot of things that just get really time consuming. Seven of Wands, please. Yeah, now you're moving on, you're planning, and you're making decisions. So people know that, you know, while you're not actively working with them, I feel like you're just busy in your own life planning and making decisions and not really trying to actively invest your time with things that are not serving you. What's coming towards you? We have Queen of Cups. So this is water energy, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer. But I feel like what's coming towards you is just really, you're getting to a more calm place in your life. And I feel like almost it's like the calm before the storm. So I feel like you guys are kind of taking the time to really understand your needs. You're really listening to your intuition. You know, you're practicing compassion with people. You're really just trying to make sure that you're emotionally stable and that you're ready to love again. So I feel like you really are working on yourself. And I feel like you're in a much better place. Okay. Why is the Queen of Cups here, please? What's coming towards Leo? What's coming towards Leo, please? Yeah, Aquarius energy. But I feel like what's coming towards you is, you know, any kind of insecurities or anything that you're discouraged or you have lost faith in, you're trying to heal it. You're trying to balance it out with the Queen of, yeah. Because I feel like you guys are coming from an... What I feel like you were in a situation where, you know, a lot of insecurities were brought up. And, you know, some of you could have been experiencing depression and just sadness. You know, in a really negative place. But I feel like you're really learning to balance it out. You're learning to balance out your emotions. I feel like you're healing yourself. And that's a beautiful place to be is, you know, where you're really starting to calm down. Everything's starting to calm. You're reminiscing now and you're realizing how you will do things differently moving on in your life. Okay. Mutual energy. We have Six of Spears. So I do feel like, you know, mutually both of you could be, you know, missing each other's attention. I feel like both of you are just going after victory and success in your own life. You know, some, you might be dealing with someone who's in the public eye or you could be in the public eye, but mutually I feel like you guys are just going after, you know, success and your happiness and pursuit. So it could be career, you know. Clarify Six of Spears. What is the mutual energy, please? Six of Spears. Yeah, you guys are just taking action. I feel like... I feel like both of you won't have something to say to one another. I feel like both of you would like to defend yourself or defend your beliefs or why you did what you did. I feel like mutually both of you want to take action for success in this connection. What is the mutual energy, please? Knight of Swords. Could definitely be a air sign. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Knight of Swords, please. Mutual energy. Yeah, it's like both of you have a lot to say to one another. I feel like you guys keep trying to move forward or keep trying to move on from the situation. But on one hand, you know that it has so much potential. And so it's really hard. It's like you move, you keep going five steps forward and then, you know, you get pulled back a little bit because you know that even though you're trying to move forward, there's so much that was left undiscovered in this connection. So I feel like both of you kind of, in a way, want to fight for this and you try to move on from it. But something always draws you back in. How this person feels about you, we have the World in reverse. So this person feels empty without you. This person feels that things are not finished between the two of you. You know, they're still in completion here. There's no closure. This person feels like you and them are not done. You know, this person wants to fix this. Why is the World here, please? I feel like that. Yeah, the Empress showed itself. Okay, so yeah, I feel like this person could be older than you, but I feel like it could be an Aries. You could have children with this person, but I feel like this person wants balance with you. They want to get things under control. Clarify the Emperor, please. Yeah, they have a lot of regrets. They're still disappointed. But I feel like with the Nine of Wands, they're also exhausted. So I feel like on one hand, they miss the connection with you. They're disappointed by how things went. But also I feel like part of them is exhausted to even come towards this. They want balance with you, but they're exhausted. Okay. Advice from Spirit, we have Death in reverse. So this is Scorpio energy, but this is like afraid of change. You know, I feel like you're holding on to something, you're afraid of change, and it, you know, could be going stagnant. But I feel like it's like if you want to resurrect something, go after it. But if you're not wanting to go back to it, put it to an end. Because I feel like you need to end something in order for transformation, in order for a metamorphosis to happen, in order for you to go on with your life. But by staying stuck, by not taking action, you're keeping yourself in limbo. So it's like it's time to move on or heal it, okay? You can't keep yourself stuck. What is the advice, please, for Leo? Yeah, I feel like you know what you need to do. This is also air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. I feel like there's something you want to say. You want to speak your mind, and you're not doing it. And I feel like, you know, I feel like everything that you've experienced, you know, you have learned lessons. You're adding value to your life. And I feel like with the Queen of Swords, you have everything that you need. You're very perceptive, and you see things very clearly. And I feel like, you know, she's holding the sword, and I feel like it's all about a breakthrough. It's about communication. And I feel like you are more prepared this time. You are guarded. I feel like there are things that you know how to articulate, things that you know you would do differently now. But I feel like it's like it's time to act, or it's time to move on. And you know what you need to do. It's going to be different from all of you. Clarify, Queen of Swords, what is the advice, please? The advice. Too many. Yeah. Queen of Wands. Yeah, this is someone who's independent. Someone who is brave. Courageous. So I feel like it's time to be brave. It's time to get the courage to speak what's on your mind. You already know what you want to do. But you see things clearly, but you're lacking the courage. Okay, so this is also fire energy. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. But I feel like no matter what you do, you are protected. With the black cat, you are protected. So make the best decision that's right for you. And oh well, you know, sometimes you get rejected. But it's if you love someone, you will never stop fighting for them, okay? So I feel like you either need to speak your mind, speak your truth, and get it off your chest, or move on. And it's going to be different from all of you, okay? All right, angels, what messages do we have for Leo, please, for love? Message for Leo, please, in regards to love. Goodness. Ooh, this deck. Huge. What message do we have for Leo, please? Ooh. Goodness gracious. Okay, so it says spiritual connection. This relationship has a connection that goes beyond this lifetime. Okay, and I feel like that's why it's hard, because there's definitely a spiritual connection here. You guys feel a tie to this person, and that's why I feel like you try to move on, but you just can't. You always go back to this person, and I feel like you're in a much better place now, and I feel like you know how you would have done things differently, or what you would or would not do. You know, you've done a lot of reflection, and I feel like this situation has to be dealt with accordingly. Like, I feel like it's time to cut the tie, or it's time to fix it, but it's going to be different for all of you. But there needs to be transformation here, and with the death in reverse, you know, someone's not making the change that they need. And consider the foundation. You are being asked to look at how committed you are to love. Okay, so how strong was your foundation? You know, what were the cracks in it? And I feel like, you know, you might have to do things completely different and, you know, let the tower come down. But now that the tower is down, you got to start on a stable foundation. So how are you going to do things differently? And I feel like you're prepared for that now. I feel like all of you have endured different scenarios, different situations, but I feel like you guys certainly have taken a lot of lessons from the situation, right? So, Leo, I'm going to leave it here. If you want a personal reading, you can get that down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I wish you guys love and light, and I will talk to you later. Bye, Leo.